Hello. In this lesson, we are going to speak about some techniques that can be used when teaching pronunciation. Well, the main techniques that can be used in general, very general, like follows. First of all, students have to listen and repeat new sounds, and then you may ask your students to classify words according to the sound they hear. And also, necessary feedback should be done and practice, so you can invite students to provide their own examples using their own sentences or find words with a concrete sound. Well, for more advanced students, you can ask, write or say sentences with contrasting sounds, create dialogues or stories or role plays using words with contrasting sounds, or use dictation technique. Well, when students, you as a teacher may dictate a list of words containing a concrete sound, and then the students may check whether they could hear the correct sound. Well, one of the techniques also we can use is brainstorming, what it means. So, for example, you may choose a specific topic you are going to speak in your class and ask students to find all words that contain a concrete sound. For example, if you would like to practice sound ts, yeah, we have example like pizza and more words. Ask your students to brainstorm a list of words or names of food that contain this sound, or a list of words contain the sounds, like, for example, if students are expected to practice the sound ch, so you may ask them to list about verbs that contain the sound, like chop, etc. Well, and it's always useful to bring pictures to make your class more interesting, more attractive for your students. So if you bring realia or its or flashcards or pictures or using PowerPoint presentation, so to make your class more interesting, more alive and more attractive for students. Well, and next technique, it can be used, it's called categorizing. Well, it can be used with different purposes. In this example, I wanted to show you how you can practice, for example, past tense endings in regular verbs. You may present a big list or long list of words in past tense that have ending ed, and ask students to classify them according to how they are pronounced, whether they are pronounced ed, like listed, or with final d, like moved, or with a final t, like in words washed. So you may ask your students to do this activity orally or in written form, then they have to classify. But since the class is teaching pronunciation, don't forget, ask your students to speak aloud and pronounce these words correctly according to how this ending should be pronounced. Dialogues and role plays are always useful technique. Well, and you can use it not only when teaching pronunciation. For example, if you during your class period you explain a specific grammar structure, you can combine this with a pronunciation element. So you may ask your students to use a concrete grammar structure and incorporate some words containing some sounds that you want your students to practice. And next very practical technique is so-called minimal pairs. Minimal pairs, you remember that they have just one sound that is different, and this sound may help students understand exactly where the difference is between sounds, especially some sounds that can cause difficulties or troubles for students to pronounce and understand why use different letter in words like base and vase when if we speak about a Spanish speaker. So you may first make your students pronounce these words, and then you can write them on board or show cards with these words for them to see the difference. And always, when it's possible and it's advisable to make your class more attractive by bringing pictures or flashcards, especially if they are children, so the class will be more alive, more interesting, and more attractive, because students can visualize words and make associations between words and images. Well, another technique that can be used is so-called minimal pair distinction. In the previous activity, students just were expected to produce the sounds. But in this technique, a minimal pair distinction is you may do it in written form. Students are given an option between two words, and they have to underline or cross out the sound that matches the sentence, the sense of the sentence. Like Geoffrey saw the pass or path and took it. So which is the correct word here? Students have to choose according to meaning. Well, you may prepare this list beforehand for your students, or you may make a kind of a competition. You may, for example, divide your class into groups and may ask one group to prepare similar sentences as you see in this slide, and another group to write another set of sentences, and then exchange between groups. Students may compete. I think this activity could be very fun for students because you know that sense of competition is always useful. Then is identification. Well, here also a teacher may give a list of words, and one word that is controlling, a controlling word, a teacher may simply pronounce this word or may bring records. For example, word fuel, and students are given three options like full, full, and fuel. So according to what was on the record, so they have to identify the correct sound and I cross it out or underline, or it's up to you how you ask your students to identify the sound. Well, and of course you can use a longer list and practice many, many different troublesome sounds for students to be able to identify. But in this technique, you remember that there is always should be a control controlling word, and this word should be pre-recorded or pronounced by teacher. Well, next, it's very challenging for students and for teachers. This technique is tongue twisters. Well, you can choose a concrete sound that you want to identify, you want your students, excuse me, to practice, and you may increase speed when pronouncing these tongue twisters for students to be able to produce sounds correctly. Or another technique you can use, it's to present students homophones and homographs for students to identify the sounds, to identify the words. You know that in homophones we have the same pronunciation, but words are different. I think when we present, when we use this technique, students have to visualize the words, the notions, in order to create correct image, and this can stimulate the memory, and they can memorize better distinction between words. If you present pictures like see and see, so they are homophones, they have similar pronunciation. So if students see and make a connection between see and I, and see it's ocean or sea, well, so it will be easier for students to make connection and use a correct word. Well, here you have more examples of homophones, and please don't forget to use bright and interesting, if it's possible, funny pictures for students to have fun and to have to simply enjoy their English class. And also another difficulty that can present in teaching pronunciation, so-called homographs. Homographs, they have identical pronunciation, but they have different meaning. Well, again, the basic element here should be pictures for students to make distinction between notions of this word, like read and read, and tire and tire. Tire, to, it's a physical condition, and part of a car, etc. So you may bring pictures, flashcards, or ask your students to prepare material and stick it on the wall in your classroom for students to always have these words in front of their eyes, and thus they can increase and improve the knowledge of sounds. Well, more homographs. Well, and some techniques for you to know. that listen and identify or choose a word is the basic technique. Then students may listen and circle a correct word, listen and write correct words. It's a make a combination of listening and speaking and writing. Well, and make a story containing contrasting sounds or role plays or using body language to represent a word, which could be very fun. Well, and listening is fundamental to speaking, and speaking, we cannot separate speaking and pronunciation. Well, so speaking about listening, we have to mention what kind of material we have to use. Should we use authentic material or something that's simplified for our students? Well, so when we choose material, it's always better to use authentic material. Well, and we can simplify the task. Well, and we can adapt our authentic material according to the needs of our students. Well, and we have to take into consideration that all tasks should depend on students' level. For example, for beginners, we can use authentic pre-recorded announcements or phone messages, something that is very short, that messages that do not contain many words. Well, and for more advanced students, we can use scripted material, lectures, etc. Well, and what you have to remember. So, instead of simplifying the language, you can use, you have to simplify the task. So, in our listening class, for listening techniques, it's better to use authentic material. We simply have to simplify the task. Well, for example, for the beginners, if we use authentic material like a lecture or something, it can be very difficult for students to understand the meaning of all the language, of all the message. But we can ask, for example, to listen for words that they could understand or words that they know. So task is very simple. They have to just identify words that they already know. And we may use the same task for more advanced students. So you see that the same material can be used for different levels of students. Well, it is very briefly, and thank you very much for your attention.